morning and welcome, Women Jika. Welcome to this year's NAIDOC celebrations. Our celebrations are going to be a little different this year with the pandemic, so we're going to have a number of pre-recordings that you'll be able to watch. So we'd like to start our celebrations today by hearing from one of our elders, Aunty Zeta, who will perform our welcome to country.
Naranik, my name is Aunty Zeta. Wamindika Wanajiri Balik, Yiman Kondibik. Welcome to the land of the Wanajiri people. Pay my respects to all the old people, our ancestors, and our elders today. I acknowledge the Bunurong tribe who we share parts of Melbourne with, and all the Kulin clans who are our neighbours. Welcome to everyone here. We have the oldest living culture on earth. Our culture is older than the Great Wall of China, the Roman Colosseum, and the pyramids of Egypt. And we have a spiritual connection to the land, the waterways, the moon, the sun, and the stars. We gain our identity through our tribal lands. The connection can be heard in our song and stories. Our stories are all around us and can be seen in our dance and artwork. I acknowledge my grandfather, Alexander McRae Briggs, born in the 1800s on Corindurk Aboriginal Reserve in a time of turmoil for our people. And because of a government policy which stated that all Aboriginal people of mixed blood were to go and assimilate into the wider community, remembering that our people were of the old ways, speakers of language, trying to live in two worlds. I acknowledge all our old leaders who petitioned government for change for our people. Why our leaders went to petition government is the horrible conditions that our people lived under. Our land was stolen, our children taken away, our language stopped, and many other things that affected our people right to this day. But now this generation is turning things around to have it like a celebration. NAIDOC is about celebrating everything that's wonderful about our people, our country now, our land, all the stories that everyone's sharing, and just celebrating in general. So happy NAIDOC, everyone. Always was, always will be.
Big thanks to Aunty Zeta for that very special welcome to country and for her personal reflections. I'd also like to commence by acknowledging the traditional owners of the land of the Kulin Nation and pay my respects to elders past, present and emerging. The NAIDOC 2020 theme, Always Was, Always Will Be, recognises our First Nations people who have occupied and cared for this continent for over 65,000 years. Our Peter Mac NAIDOC celebration is designed to inspire reflection of our First Nations' long history of this country, our Australian history. It's a way to commemorate and honour the oldest continuing cultures on the planet and to recognise that sovereignty was never ceded. Each year, NAIDOC Week celebrations are usually held in July across the nation to commemorate and celebrate history, culture and achievements of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people. Due to the pandemic, NAIDOC Week was delayed until this week in November. At this important time, I think it's really important that we acknowledge the efforts of the Aboriginal community and BACCHO in keeping the number of COVID cases in Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander communities down, with only 74 cases out of 58,000 people in Victoria. It's an incredible effort, and we're proud to have VACHO as one of our important partners. This is an incredibly important celebration for Peter Mac. We're committed to being an inclusive and culturally safe workplace and are grateful to all those in our extended family of patients, carers and staff who have helped to improve cancer outcomes and the care experiences for our patients attending Peter Mac. So now I'd like to introduce you to our Chief Executive Officer, Shelley Dolan. Shelley is also the Chair of the Reconciliation Action Plan. So welcome, Shelley.
Thank you very much, Geri and Auntie Zeta, and all of our guests who are here with us today, and indeed all of you that are watching this either now or will be able to watch it later. So can I too acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which we are meeting? I pay my respects to their elders, past, present and emerging, and all of the Aboriginal communities across the whole of Australia. Peter Mac reaches across the whole of Australia, and we do that with the utmost respect for our First People, who, as Geri has just said, are the single longest continuum of First Peoples across the planet. Improving Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander cultural safety is a really important focus for all health services, and it has been a focus at Peter Mac for some time. So NAIDOC Week is a wonderful opportunity for us to share with everybody some of the ways we are seeking to improve how we respond to the individual needs of every member of the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander community. And of course, to do that, we need to learn. So we need to be aware, and we need to steep ourselves in the cultural heritage that Auntie Zeta and Geri have just talked about. So setting up our Reconciliation Action Plan Committee is a big step forward for us, as is the recent development of our Reconciliation Action Plan, which is going towards its last stages of development. This action plan is not something that's just going to sit on a shelf. It is very much a living document so that we can change and revitalize how we approach cultural safety here at Peter Mac. It was fantastic to see such a high level of engagement. We put an invitation out across Peter Mac, and actually it was difficult to see everybody on Zoom because so many people replied. And I'm looking forward to a time when we can sit together and share stories together. And I really look forward to that time. Also during NAIDOC Week, we are very keen to take practical, positive steps forward to empower our staff. And as I said earlier, to raise awareness and to have a real understanding of the needs of our Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander patients, families and communities. So today I'm really pleased to launch the new online Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander cultural awareness training. This training has been developed by and for all Victorian health services with very specific purpose in mind. And it's a really important construct, if you like, to help us bridge the gap between health outcomes in our First People and in the rest of Australian society. And we here at Peter Mac need to lead this work very much in cancer care. So cancer, 1 in 2 people risk in their lifetime. So really important disease, and really important that we concentrate very hard on reducing any gap. So this is all about education, and it's for all of us. As you all know, I have only been here a year, so I am very keen to be as aware as I can be and to learn everything I can. I've already learned a lot from Jay, who you will hear from later, and from Auntie Pam and others, but I think all of us are keen to learn as much as we can. So This education will improve the way we respond to specific needs, and it will help us support people in the best way possible. The modules are focused on strengthening understanding and appreciation for the diverse and multifaceted cultures, practices, and histories of our First Nation people. And as we've heard, these histories and stories span thousands of years. And so this is a long process for us, but one we are very, very eager to start. The education focuses on the importance of taking ownership of our own education and learning more, as I say, and helping to empower everybody in our society, and particularly our First People. The core objectives of the modules are to provide a detailed insight into the history of Australia and articulate the impact and trauma of historical events and colonialist policy on Aboriginal health. To understand the importance of creating culturally safe health services as critical to bridging the gap in those outcomes that I've talked about, and above all, to celebrate our Aboriginal colleagues and the value and knowledge they bring to our teams and organisations. And finally, to understand how we best create and sustain a workplace environment where we will be attracting Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders to come and work here. It will be a place that is known as culturally safe. And this is not just a one-off initiative. This is for us to change Peter Mac now and for always. And that's really, really important. The training is delivered in four separate modules. Three are mandatory for every single staff member at Peter Mac. So this is not tokenist, this is all of us learning and raising our awareness. And I'm very confident that this will help us on a journey to greater inclusivity and appropriate cultural safety. Now that's enough from me. We're now going to view a part of the wonderful and vivid culture that we've been talking about. And we're going to see a dance by the Djirri Djirri dancers. This welcome dance, or I'm going to say this wrong, but I'm going to try, Womenjika, uses leaves throughout the dance as a symbol of cleansing. The older girls who have been through their coming of age ceremony are wearing possum belts, and you will see the beautiful possum cloak here behind me. And the younger girls are wearing emu feathers. So let's all enjoy the dance.
Our first dance is our welcome dance that calls on our ancestors from the north, south, east and west. It is also to welcome visitors onto this country. We use leaves throughout the dance as they are a symbol of cleansing. You can also see that we are wearing our possum skin belts. Here's mine. And we earn these belts after we attend a coming of age ceremony. The younger girls of the group wear an emu feather skirt as they haven't been through the ceremony yet. And on the inside of our skirt, we actually carve our totems. So mine's Gunawara, the black swan. So here is our Womenjika welcome dance.
Warangere, warangere, ya, naramo.
Culturally sensitive communication and interaction with our Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander patients. The guide was designed as a reference tool to support us in better understanding the needs of our Aboriginal patients and carers. It was designed in response to what our staff told us they needed. So this guide, available on the internet, really came about from a number of conversations that we've had from staff who say they felt uncomfortable and anxious. They're scared they're going to say the wrong thing. So it's interesting because I had a similar conversation with Aunty Pam Pedersen, who's the chair of our Aboriginal Advisory Committee, about saying the right thing. And Aunty Pam's response was, no questions too silly. We're just happy that you asked the questions. So we gathered up some of these issues and put them in this guide for you. So the sorts of things you'll find in this guide is where the various Aboriginal clans are found within Victoria, how to engage with our Aboriginal patients in a culturally sensitive manner, which special days are extremely relevant and why. It lists appropriate language and terminology. The guide also provides information for our staff about where to find additional resources to support our patients. The guide's available, as I said, on iPolicy, and I really encourage everyone to have a read of it. It's a short read, but it's a very useful document. Just print it off and have it next to your desk. So it's now my pleasure to introduce Jay Hamann. So Jay's been with us for over a year now, but has recently increased to full-time here at Peter Mac to ensure that we can better support our Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander patients. And as Shelley said, we've all learnt a lot from Jay, so we're very grateful to have her here with us. And so Jay is going to share her story of what NAIDOC means to her. Thank you, Jay.
Thank you, Geri. Hi, everyone. My name's Jay Hamann, Aboriginal Hospital Liaison here at Peter Mac. And I'm born and raised here in Melbourne in the northern suburbs on Wurundjeri country. But my ancestors, well, my ancestral line is from Point Pitt, South Australia, Narungaland, and very proud of that. So I'm here to talk about what NAIDOC means to me. And I guess NAIDOC's one of my favourite, I guess, holidays or events of the year, and it brings childhood memories. I've been involved with NAIDOC my whole life. I've always known about NAIDOC, going to NAIDOC events, being with community. To me, it's about coming together, celebrating, being proud of our culture and what we have to offer, and get to share that with family and friends. And also get to catch up with people that we haven't seen in a long time and just really enjoy our culture and getting together, and especially seeing the kids getting involved. We have lots of events for kids where they get to do cultural activities, and one of my favourites is our Elders Lunch on. I'm very sad that we don't get to have our Elders Lunch on this year. And it's going to be a very different year this year with NAIDOC, but I'm excited to see what everyone brings forth through Zoom, because that's the way of the world right now. And that's it from me. Thank you, Aunty Zeta, and thank you to the Djirri Djirri dancers. You just did an amazing job. And that's it. Thank you.
Thanks, Jay. And as I said, we're very lucky to have Jay here on our staff. Before we conclude, we'll have another dance by the Geri Djirri dancers. This one's called Bullen Bullen.
Our last dance is the lyrebird dance, the Bullen Bullen Yaga. And the lyrebird in this symbolises the male finding his female by having the strongest and most powerful voice. And he teaches us language because he knows all the language of animals. Usually when we're in person, we would dance off stage and say our thank yous before we dance. So I'd just like to thank Peter Mac staff, audience, and more importantly, our Aboriginal and non-Aboriginal patients for watching. I hope you have a great day and enjoy our dances. Ngodjin, thank you. Thank you, everyone, for joining us. That completes our NAIDOC Week event this morning. However, on Thursday, we do have a very special guest. Uncle Robbie Bundle will be joining our very own music therapist, Stefan, on Thursday at 2 p.m. on Zoom, the usual, well, I think it might be YouTube, but the usual format. I'd like to thank you all for joining us today. And anyone who missed the event, our fantastic comms team will make sure that the recording's available. So happy NAIDOC event.